since caveman days, it was very obvious to even the simplest individual that if you didn't have food, you lost weight. And if you did lots and lots of exercise and ran, you tended to lose weight. Or conversely, if you ate a whole lot, you tended to gain weight. So we conclude because these activities, eating and exercise, alter body weight, we conclude that's the cause of obesity. And it's so much more complicated than that, that what we have to say now is we should treat diet and exercise the way it's treated for the diseases of, for example, diabetes or high blood pressure or a number of other diseases.
A common misperception about obesity is that it's simply a matter of eating healthy and being more physically active, and that those behaviors are simply the choice of the individual. But in reality, we know there's so many other things that influence how easy it is for an individual to adopt a healthy lifestyle.
A few years ago when I looked, there were 60 genes that had been identified as being involved in some way with food intake or satiety or appetite or exercise or energy metabolism or the type of substrate that's used to make energy, to run the fuel for the body, whether it's fat or whether it's carbohydrate or whatever. But if you do the factorial, if you think about the mix, 60 times 59 times 58 times 57, that gives you all the variations of those 60 genes. It's something like 10 to the 81st or something. There are more kinds of obesity on Earth than there have ever been people or will be people. So almost certainly there is no person on Earth who has exactly the same type of obesity.
While seeking treatment for obesity, I understand that it is not very easy to lose weight. And what that does is makes people vulnerable to various quacks and quackery and gimmick. And it attracts them because they promise something that doesn't exist. They promise a very simple, smooth, quick weight loss that can be maintained forever and without effort. If somebody promises that, you almost always want to suspect and stop and question if it is really true, if it is really scientific. So, as they say, if it sounds too good to be true, it is too good to be true. So, especially in the field of obesity, one needs to be very aware of these dangers and be constantly be thinking whether is it a legitimate scientific, evidence-based treatment that you are seeking.
Evidence-based treatment is a term that describes treatments that are backed up by studies. Evidence-based treatment for obesity is a treatment approach that has been carefully tested and vetted and summarized by professionals who, you know, do that for a living.